Hey guys, it's Darian Nguyen of Lab Shenanigans, and welcome back to my channel. The title of this video is The History of Science Misinformation in the Past 100 Years. I actually spent more time researching on this topic, or I guess researching these stories, much longer than I anticipated. I found myself just reading stories about like pseudoscience, conspiracy theories, fake news, science misinformation, science disinformation. What's the difference? Misinformation is false or inaccurate information, especially that which is deliberately intended to deceive. Disinformation, false information which is intended to mislead, especially propaganda issued by a government organization to a rival power or the media. I spent a lot of time just like reading these stories, and it was really hard to try to put them all together in a video without, I guess, like getting off topic. I wanted to focus on the major events in history that swayed the public's opinion on a certain topic without really like diving into conspiracy theories. All right, let's get started, shall we? 1923, the eugenics movement reaches its height. It was a movement to control human breeding so that people with the quote-unquote best genes would reproduce, and thus the human species would improve. It was championed by a very prominent biologist, Charles Davenport, and this movement told racist people what they wanted to hear: that certain races are superior in such traits like intelligence, hard work, cleanliness, and so on.
1938. I remember that year like it was yesterday.
1938 was when Orson Welles' War of the Worlds was broadcasted on the radio. And because the radio was so brand new at the time, a lot of people bought into this story.
What?
Allegedly, public panic broke loose when people thought that an actual alien invasion was happening. In the 1950s, fluoridation of public water supplies was met with widespread public resistance. So the aim of adding fluorine to water is to help prevent tooth decay. However, opponents claim that the benefits are exaggerated or not established, which is not true because there are a lot of studies that have been published stating that adding fluorine to water is actually very beneficial to your teeth. 1954, for the first time, American tobacco companies posted an ad called A Frank Statement to Cigarette Smokers to create doubt in the public eye by disputing scientific studies linking smoking to lung cancer and other dangerous health effects. These tobacco companies funded think tanks and lobbying groups, ran advertisements in medical journals, started health reassurance campaigns, and they also researched alternate explanations for lung cancer. So in the 1960s, the sugar industry funded research that downplayed the risks of sugar and its association with heart disease. These studies incorrectly suggested that
fat makes you fat, end of story.
Fat is to blame for weight gain and obesity. Baby, that's a gag. 1968, monosodium glutamate. I already made a video on this, but I feel like it's so important that I have to bring it back and put it in this video as well. 1968, monosodium glutamate, or MSG, which is a flavor enhancer, gets a bad reputation when a journal published a letter from an American doctor who wrote that he experienced some symptoms very similar to an allergic reaction when he ate at a Chinese restaurant. He then referred to this set of symptoms as Chinese restaurant syndrome. This idea that MSG is bad for your health still persists today and is fueled by xenophobia. 1976. Bill Kaysing, a former contributor to the US space program, writes a pamphlet called We Never Went to the Moon, America's $30 billion swindle, in which he includes grainy photographs and outlandish theories about the moon landing. Funny enough, it took 400 NASA employees to put Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin on the moon, but it only took one person to spread the idea that that event didn't happen, that it's all a joke. The power that this man has.
The intelligence that that has, the influence that that has, the profile that that has.
What?
Today, there are more than 10,000 cases of AIDS in the United States.
The Patriot newspaper publishes an article, AIDS May Invade India, Mystery Disease Caused by US Experiments. The false story was picked up by major newspapers and cited an anonymous American scientist suggesting a new deadly disease had been created by the Pentagon in a bid to develop new biological weapons. This article was part of a campaign called Operation Infection in the 80s to plant the idea that the US had invented... I can't even say it. The US had invented HIV and AIDS. What the...
Essential Insurance,
without. So in the 1990s, oil companies like Chevron, Exxon, and Shell pushed climate denial in the news media. And there's a huge scientific consensus that global surface temperatures have increased in recent decades. However, these oil companies have spent billions of dollars to control the climate change conversation, and they continue to do so. Right now, America's oil companies are trying to rebrand themselves as part of the solution to the whole climate crisis, when in fact, they're the ones who are huge contributors to this issue.
Fire!
Wind! Water!
Heart!
Go Planet!
By your powers combined, I am Captain Planet!
Captain Planet!
1996 was the year we first saw the Got Milk advertisement, which was part of a series of an advertising campaign to increase dairy consumption. These ads told us that milk is essential to our diet. We must drink milk to be healthy.
Want to grow?
If we wanted strong bones,
the calcium in milk helps bones grow.
So we had to drink milk. This is all untrue. Milk can be part of a healthy diet, but it is not a necessity. Milk is a good source of calcium, but it isn't necessarily the most critical factor for bone health. But yet, it is recommended by the dietary guidelines for Americans. Turns out, the dairy industry gives millions of dollars to politicians who protect their interests whenever the nutrition guidelines come up for review.
If your study is a lie, your book is a lie.
Study is not a lie. The findings that we made have been replicated in.
Sir, that's not true. You've been offered the chance to replicate your study, and you've never taken anybody up on that.
In 1998, a British doctor by the name of Andrew Wakefield, I feel like some of you guys might already know this story, but it's muy importante to science history, so I feel like I have to bring it up, falsely claimed that the measles, mumps, and rubella vaccine, you already know, may predispose children to behavioral regression and pervasive developmental disorders leading to autism. The media seized these stories, igniting public fear and confusion over the safety of vaccines. So the journal that originally published Wakefield's work said they should have never published a paper, and then in 2010 retracted the paper, but at that point the damage was already done and it was too late.
There's just a vibration with GMOs, something that I don't want to put into my body.
We don't have the vibrational frequency to host that virus.
And I taught her that.
So if you don't have that vibrational frequency right here, you're not gonna get it.
In the late 1990s and early 2000s, the public's concern over the purity and naturalness of food increases with a focus on added ingredients and whether or not a food has been genetically modified. By 2014, 57% of the public think that genetically modified foods are unsafe to eat. In 2014, the Daily Observer, which is a Liberian newspaper, published an article alleging that the Ebola virus was not a medical disaster, but rather a bioweapon designed by the US to depopulate the planet. A few weeks later, Chris Brown tweeted his then 13 million followers, "I don't know, but I think this Ebola epidemic is a form of population control." It is getting crazy, bruh.
That this virus could well have come from a laboratory.
More recently, in 2020, an article posted to Zenodo, an open access website for sharing research papers, claimed that genetic evidence showed the SARS-CoV-2 virus was made in a lab.
I have studied viruses for 15 years and consider many of them close friends.
This paper was led by Chinese virologist Li Mengyan, who claims that this evidence of genetic engineering has been censored in scientific journals. Several virologists immediately called out the paper for being completely unscientific. Turns out her paper also accused academic journalists of plotting with conspirators by censoring important evidence.
What did he say?
Yes. Alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that future Darian puts a lot of effort into this video and edits this video like crazy. I hope you guys enjoyed it and you learned something. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and also turn on the bell notification. Am I forgetting something? I am forgetting something. Thank you to everyone who commented a corn emoji on not last week's video. I didn't post a video last week. This week's shout out goes to Megan Nickerson. Congratulations, you are the winner of free Lab Shenanigans merch. If you want a chance to win free Lab Shenanigans merch, and if you want a shout out in my next video, comment down below
an alien emoji.
Sweet, thank you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you.